So we'll start by settling the body, finding a stable, comfortable, upright position serviceable for meditation. So we think about keeping our feet flat and our back straight, torso open, hands in the lap right over left with the palms upturned and the thumbs gently touching. Our eyes are gently closed or slightly open, making sure we let in enough light to remain alert. We try to avoid slouching or leaning. We also let go of unnecessary tension or rigidity in the body, relaxing into a stable, comfortable, upright position. We generate a sense of letting go of attending to the environment, allowing sights and sounds to be as they are without investigation. Concentrating that awareness in the present by attending closely to the physical sensation of the air moving into and back out the tip of the nostrils. Noticing quickly when anything other than that one physical sensation is arising in the mind, and without judgment or frustration, lifting our awareness up from those distractions and placing it gently but firmly again and again on the breath. And then when the mind feels more calm, generate a broad and altruistic motivation for your time. Wanting to use your time to establish and deepen beneficial, constructive ways of thinking and acting. Ways that allow oneself to maintain a sense of peace and ease. Cultivating these mental states that when they arise, naturally lend themselves to engaging in actions that are beneficial for others. Wanting to reduce and ultimately eliminate the tendencies, the habits, the ways of perceiving and acting that agitate and disturb the mind. That when they are strongly present, give rise to actions that cause harm for others. Thinking of fundamentally transforming the mind in this way in order to be of greater and greater benefit to sentient beings over time. And then with that motivation, I'll briefly return to attending to the breath. Try to attend to the rhythmic nature of the in-breath and the out-breath. Becoming aware of the entire cycle. Breathing naturally and normally. Then begin to broaden your awareness. Noticing the spaciousness of the mind itself, the stage in which perception of the breath was occurring. Allow your attention to observe without attachment to whatever naturally arises and abides and dissolves within the field of awareness. Concentrate on the mind like the sky and individual objects of awareness like clouds forming and passing away. how to recognize that by identifying with a spacious, open clarity of the mind, we have freedom to choose which thoughts to follow and which to let go of. Try to bring to mind some recent experiences where the mind got caught in ways of thinking that weren't not productive, where that sense of spaciousness was lost. It seemed like only the painful state of mind was present. And imagine cultivating the ability to recognize that simply is one of the clouds practice cultivating that spaciousness around what previously seemed like the whole of our awareness, that which dominated the mind. And then consider, too, the freedom to rely on the thoughts that are valid, that are supportive. That are useful. Bring to mind what some examples of those are for you. And recognize that you also have the freedom to focus on those positive, constructive ideas and beliefs. So try to now cultivate that reliance and coming back to those beneficial points of view. And then when you're ready, we'll come back together. And I'll dedicate. So recollect your altruistic motivation. And think that by having engaged in this contemplation, you've actualized that motivation, created positive energy in the mind. And think that you freely offer the fruit of your practice for the benefit of all sentient beings without exception. Thinking may that positive energy serve as a cause and condition to eliminate war and conflict, poverty, famine, disease, disaster, all painful inner and outer conditions. Thinking may it fully ripen the minds of all sentient beings. May they quickly meet perfect teachers and arise in the state of full enlightenment. May I too achieve the state of enlightenment in order to work for the benefit of sentient beings perfectly. May any obstacles facing the Guru's long life be completely dissolved. And may I and all sentient beings in this moment come under the joyful care and guidance of enlightened beings. May we be guided and protected until we swiftly achieve that state of enlightenment. Thank you.